In this guide, we'll look at the arm action for the backstroke technique and cover the three phases from start to finish. First, we look at the arm entry, then the pull, and finally, the recovery. In backstroke, the arms move in an alternating pattern. One arm is recovering above the waterline, whilst the other is pulling through the water, propelling you forward. The positioning and rolling motion of the body is important here to allow the correct entry point for the arm into the water. Getting the right arm positioning allows engagement of your chest and back muscles to help produce a powerful pulling phase. Let's begin by looking at the entry phase of the arm action. Ensure the arm is rotated so the palm is facing out. You're aiming to create as little drag as possible during this initial phase. Your upper arm should brush your ear and enter the water first, followed by elbow, forearm and hand, little finger first. Allow your body to rotate towards the arm as it enters the water. Next up is the pulling phase. Don't immediately pull with your hand after it enters the water, as this will create resistance. Instead, turn your palm so it's facing the bottom of the pool. Bend your elbow and scull your hand outwards and downwards until it reaches a position in line between your upper chest and shoulders. Your elbow should now be bent to around a 90-degree angle. At this point, rotate your hand again so your palm is facing towards your feet. Then push through the water until your arm is fully extended by your thigh and ready to be lifted out of the water for the recovery. Finally, let's look at the recovery phase. When exiting the water with your arm, you should lead with your thumb. The arm should be lifted out by the movement of the shoulder and not the other way around. Make sure you keep your arm straight during this recovery until it re-enters the water. So there you have it, a guide that covers the whole backstroke arm action.